What is up, everybody? Tanner here, and ready to begin our podcast. Sorry, we haven't done one in a while. It's been a crazy amount of time. And I am not alone today. No, Shy Guy isn't with me. He's off in his Pokemon journey playing Pokemon Go. Cue the sad music.
But I'm here for you.
I just got a boner, or if I just got scared.
The quick answer is both. Okay, I'm done with that now.
Important. We can't handle being around each other. That's all I can say.
Yeah, you get your own private little room to record in. I have to talk into a mic, you know, while there are other people trying to sleep, so...
Oh, trust me. Bye.
I get to talk in this voice the entire time.
Everyone around me can hear it, like in the neighboring rooms.
That must be really inconvenient when you want to do naughty things.
Oh, I know it is. It's terrible.
But anyway, on to our
things. Have you ever thought? So you know Urban Dictionary?
Are you asking me or?
I'm asking you, not the viewers. Of you, they're gonna yell at me and probably put my name into Urban Dictionary and ask for a definition.
Well, yes, I do know about Urban Dictionary.
Today we are playing a game based around the magic website of Urban Dictionary.
And I'm the one who brought up this idea, not Tanner, just so it goes for the record.
I'm not that creative a person, you know that?
Which is, and I'm kind of surprised that I didn't recognize it, because this, you'll see this challenge, like, all over the place.
Oh, yeah.
Or this game, I guess. I don't know if it's a challenge so much, but do you want to explain the rules, or should I?
Alright, let's ask Urban Dictionary what rules are.
Okay, while he's doing that, I'll explain the rules of the game.
Sucks. Wait, never mind, I'm gonna scroll down. Something that is higher in quality than all other things. Peanut M&M's rules. Things that are made to be broken. Huh.
Okay, on to the actual thing, though. So the Urban Dictionary challenge is, or game, or whatever the fuck you want to call it, is... a game where you have, you know, at least two people who look for, you know, basically random words on the Urban Dictionary website and then try to find out what the definition is, just totally based off of what it says it is, and then they confirm to see what it actually is by, you know, looking up the definition for it. And we've decided that we're going to have, you know, a point system here, but we haven't exactly determined what the reward will be for winning and what the unfortunate displeasure would be for losing.
Or ice cream.
You know, I'm good with ice cream. I'm looking forward to you owing me ice cream.
If you want.
A what?
A side video of us awarding you with ice cream.
I'm totally okay with that.
Oh, cool.
Or expect to give me ice cream. No, you're gonna be giving me ice cream.
We'll see about that.
Just straight up. Right now, I can say that much.
We'll see about that.
Alright. So here, I'll go ahead and look aboard here, and... Cool. Alright, so... Alright, this is the first word. Avant-core.
A what?
Avant-core.
Alright, and then we have to guess off of the definition that Urban Dictionary gives us, what the actual definition is?
We have to see what the actual... No, we just have to see what the Urban Dictionary it says, like, is the definition, based off of its title here. Also, the only thing that you have to go off of is Avante. And that's it. You have to... What does Avante mean?
Avante. I'm gonna say, Well, I got what Urban Dictionary says. Should I read that or no?
Oh, well, you already... we're going to do a different word because you looked it up. Okay. Here. A different word. Magic stick. This probably would be a bit better.
Okay. Well, I got a couple definitions for that one. I don't have to look up anything to do that. I would say do I just say my definition?
Yes.
Well, which definition do you want?
You only have one definition. You can only use one.
Well, how do I say this? A magic stick is, currently in my pants.
And?
Yeah,
details here.
Okay, details.
Well, we need to know the specifics. Like, you know, how... Okay, continue.
Let's see. I'd say it is in my pants, and it does magical things to make me feel better about life and my sadness and how much I wish I could drink bleach when I can't.
I'm going to just go along the same lines, but I'm just going to straight up say it's a penis. Magic stick means penis.
No, mine wasn't a penis, it was a dick. There's a difference.
So you're saying that you have Dick Cheney in your pants, because holy crap, those are some giant pants if you can fit a politician in there.
Oh, like, the lies. That's like a bunch of lies in a relationship right there. You don't want that.
Yeah, so then the definition is... an extremely satisfying stick that the ladies can't go without in bed. A penis or a dick. And then the example sentence is... Sam sings, "Yo, Andrew, I got the magic stick!" Andrew, "For shizzle, yo, at least all the girls tell me that shit." And that is legit what the little example sentence is there. It's, you know, I'll say we both got a point on that one. Alright.
Okay, point?
Alright.
I can't snap, so, official snapper, will you please snap
me? I did it for you. Here.
Oh, you'll snap me? Oh, that was beautiful.
Yeah.
A penis that the owner uses to please others. A black dude dick that pleases many people.
Alright, next word. Go on, gotta keep this moving.
Okay,
keep this moving. Keep it. Flowing.
Flowing. I was about to say my income, but that's a lie. Flowing. I will say, my parents' disappointment is the definition.
Of what?
Of flowing.
That's not a word. I'm saying you need to look up a word now.
Oh, I thought you were saying flowing.
Now, saying one thing while you were saying one thing, and you just happened to stop saying something as I was saying flowing.
Okay, let's see. Disappointment. Disappoint. Is it gonna work? Ment. Okay, the word here is disappointment.
Disappointment?
Yes. Because I thought that my definition just kind of brought out the happiness in the world. So I kind of want to do that.
I'm going to guess that the answer is going to be...
Who's that? I'm kidding. I'm going to say the definition is, either Dergistan, or, Dergistan, Shy Guy, or my whole life as a whole. Like, if you guys want to know, like, my whole life is kind of a disappointment currently. Like, just the other day I was trying to drink bleach, and apparently I choked on the bleach, and I didn't get to drink it all.
You should use Drano. It's a bit more painful, but it's a more basic solution, so it'll actually dissolve your throat faster.
Oh, okay, thank you. Thank
the more you know.
Hashtag true friendship.
PSA, seriously, don't drink bleach, you freaking idiots.
Please, please don't love me. Alright, so I'm gonna say disappointment is myself. That's my definition. And yours, your definition is me.
Yeah.
I don't know how attacked I should feel. Let's see what Urban Dictionary says. Let's see, disappointment. A time when someone lets you down. Oh, dude, that's a real disappointment. That's one of their definitions.
Boring. Okay.
All right. That's their only definition.
Alright, so, wait. What's that over there? There's something over in the corner there. What is that? Who dat? What?
Whoa! Shy Guy appeared!
Wow, this is such a surprise and totally not staged. Whoa, set up. Hello. It's nice to meet you again.
Deep voice off.
Now let's add Shy Guy to the scoreboard. One, two, three, kids, clap!
Alright, so... Okay, yeah, I found another word that I think is worth using. Psycho cunt.
Psycho cunt?
Yes. You might need to stick a vulgarity warning at the beginning of this, because this is gonna get hard.
I'm gonna say,
That was a joke.
Let's think about this for a second.
Taylor's ex-girlfriend.
Which one?
I don't have to worry about that, because I've never had an ex-girlfriend.
Oh, dear. We're all just attacking each other today.
Yeah.
Let's begin. The definition of psycho cunt is... Let's go into the deep... the deep shit of it all. I'm gonna say, the definition is psychotic and cunty, like Shy Guy. That's my definition.
Okay.
Or actually, no, I'm gonna say it's actually, I'm gonna say it's just a cunt that takes things a little bit too far.
Alright. That's it?
Alright, yep, that's my definition. What do you think?
Alright. Well, how about you say what your thought is on the matter?
Psychopunt. AKA Hypno-Vagina. Now, with the psychopunt...
I do not want to add that to the... Like, I don't want to focus on that.
Now, what the psychopunt does is a pendulum drops out of a taco-like experience and swings back and forth until it hypnotizes you, trapping you in a relationship you don't want to be in. We had plans, Melissa. Just kidding, I don't know anyone named Melissa. But, psychocon.
Okay, you know,
any ex-girlfriend that you've
had? I can understand that.
Any ex-girlfriend that you've had? Oh, dude, best definition for psychocon, right here. Ready? Harley Quinn.
Oh, fine. So, here's my guess, and mine's pretty simple, it's just a really crazy, angry lady. I mean,
the old lady.
I don't know what you said, Tanner, but I'm just remembering, you know, what Shy Guy said about a hypnotic lady parts.
Well, I'm curious how many dislikes we can get on this video.
If we can get 5,000 dislikes on this face reveal
for a Shy Guy. Alright, so the official definition for a psycho cunt is a woman who has one or more serious personality defects like emotional immaturity, impulsive behavior, narcissistic self-image, ADD, and severe neurosis, so that one cannot reason with them in a dispute and cannot maintain a healthy relationship. Usually a psycho cunt will seem like a good friend until a problem occurs, at which point they get irrational, overdramatic, and frenzied, so that you can't work out the issue. Eventually, one must disassociate themselves from a psycho cunt because they will not compromise or reason. And then the example is, Courtney is a psycho cunt. She would not let me tell my side of the story. Courtney, the psycho cunt, won't stop screwing every guy she meets. She is so insecure, she can't go a day without a boyfriend.
AKA Harley Quinn.
Yeah.
AKA almost all my exes. Keyword almost.
AKA Shy Guy.
Oh my. Right. You know, I feel like I'm the winner here.
I don't even remember what yours was.
Oh, I pretty much said just, you know, a cunt. No, that's what he said.
I think if anything, me and Shy Guy and I get a point, but you don't.
Here, how about this? I'll get 1 point, one full point, and I'll give you guys half a point.
I know.
I'm gonna say half a point on three. One, two, and three. I don't know what that was. That was just kind of a thing.
Okay.
Put a little ding there, please. Okay, thank you. Alright, on to the next definition, shall we? Shy Guy, you ready? Alright, so the word will be, let's see, I don't know, I'm feeling rather, adventurous today. The word today will be American.
American?
The exact same thing when his girlfriend broke up with him. She looked her in the eyes and said, I'm feeling rather adventurous today, and she's like, Tanner, we're done.
I got nothing to say to that, actually.
Alright, so I'm going to say that the Urban Dictionary definition for American is going to be something like a large, physically, you know, fat person who tends to go out to eat at the less savory fast food joints, and yeah, and let's see, and they have weird interests and hobbies. I'm not saying that they're bad or anything, but weird.
I'm a weeaboo. I'm a fucking weeaboo.
Oh, yeah, fun fact about actually that. So you know how tentacle porn is a thing? You can actually blame the Americans for the creation of it.
Dude, we can blame Americans for Squidonster.
Yes.
Hentai.
Yes, you can.
They're on a boat, and a squid monster, or a squonster, comes and pleasures them with his squenticles. Squid tentacles. Squenticles.
That's because the Americans, when they came to Japan, were so upset with the just casual nudity of people that they shamed, you know, normal pornography to the point where it's like, okay, you know, dicks, absolutely not. But, you know, anything that's not a dick.
Like squid.
And that is why Americans caused hentai.
I am.
The more you know.
Say that. Other than, I'm gonna buy a squid soon.
Squid monster.
Why do you guys think I eat sushi so much? Why do you think I like to eat sushi alone?
Oh dear.
All Tanner's friends are heathens with Squid Onster. They like to feel his tentacles up his bum, rump, fanny. Please don't make any sudden moves. You don't know how Squid Onster
is. I don't know if I can ever listen to 21 Pilots again after hearing that. Alright. I'm gonna say my definition of Americans is not all of them are overweight, but quite a bit of them are. They are mostly rednecks. They. I just got flashed, guys.
By Squid Hunter.
Great.
No. We're not saying it out loud.
Let's
just say Squid Hunter flashed his face on the screen.
Those lazy Americans.
How about this? From here on out, I am going to say the words, and it's just going to be a competition between you guys. Two of you.
Squid Hunter.
No, it's okay. I got you. It's okay.
Alright.
We didn't even finish up this round yet.
Oh, yeah.
This round, every point will be worth 5 points.
Alright.
Oh, gosh. Alright. So, yeah, that's my definition of American, I guess.
Alright.
Shy Guy, do you have any definition for American?
Pornhub.
Okay, then.
Yes. I am.
So what's the official definition?
The official definition says... That's a really long definition. Oh, I don't know if I want to read that. It's like 4 paragraphs. Let's get started. Technically, an American is someone of the Americas, i.e.
Summarize.
America. However, it is commonly referring to the people of the USA that will just...
Wait, hold on. They said an American is people from the Americas, North or South. So that doesn't mean someone in Brazil is technically an American. And wouldn't that make them not an illegal immigrant, Donald Trump?
United States of America versus...
Are we building a wall across the whole America's end?
Well, actually, the majority, you know, another fun fact for you, the majority of illegal immigration actually isn't across a border, but actually coming into a border through legitimate means and then just not leaving when they're supposed to.
Pretty much.
True story.
You know, plus there's also, you know, tunnels and people can also fly here and also, you know.
It's not just that, it's like just straight up, like, they come with a visa and then it's like, okay, I'm not leaving.
It's like, I'm in this country, fuck you guys, I'm staying. Give me a lawn to mow.
Oh, that got racist.
Why do you think I stand on this?
Good point.
I do not condone any of his actions. I am. You guys think you guys have a chance? I'm gonna beat you to the shot. Yeah, basically it says, they do some weird things though. They call football soccer. They call football football. Aluminum, I can't pronounce it, jam, jelly, and so on, battling them for differences like that. Let's see, what else have we got? Americans, yes, okay, that's an even longer term. Legal residence in the United States, not that, okay, this is too scientific for me. I'm not an American, so just shrug.
We have a good enough, I think we have a good enough definition.
Ooh, our country can kick ass. Our culture is so much better. Answer Japanese manufacturing cell phones. Be got it in European, whatever, you greedy capitalist yanks. Observe. Guys, shut up. You both sound like idiots. You know what? I know that we're all pretty much tied except Chai Guy. So, hey. I'm gonna say, I definitely didn't get a point.
Alright, I think we might need to speed things up just a little bit here.
I agree. Okay, well, I'm gonna give... Yeah, I'll be nice. I'll give Durgistan the point. Give him point. Go! Oh, that wasn't the ding I was hoping for. Here's a ding. There you go. Okay. I don't want your... You'll never take the job of the computer, Shy Guy.
There are a few comments that say this is my channel now, so fuck you, Tanner.
Yeah.
I don't get that problem with my channel. I own it.
Let's talk with you.
Yeah.
Well, the hate today is just... Yeah.
Hey, I suck the galactic as much as possible.
What the absolute?
Okay. Here's a word I...
Okay.
Switch.
No, actually, we've been going for like more than 30 minutes. Okay, let's do a final word, because we get distracted really easy.
It seems like these are always rubbish.
You know what? I think our final words should be rubbish.
Rubbish?
Actually, no, that's too lazy. Give us something, eccentric.
Alright.
Which day? The final word must be good.
Cuck.
Okay, you. I'm going to spend some time looking for a final word for the two of you guys.
Cuck.
Okay.
See you.
Right. Okay. You keep talking. This is going to take a little while.
Alright. Well,
welcome back to the Shy Guy and Tanner Show.
Hi.
Today, on our episode, we have Ghost Gengar.
Gengar!
Just kidding, we don't. We have a guest, Tanner. Welcome to the pad. How may we help you?
Thanks for reminding me of your show, Shy Guy. I am happy to be here. And, I would just like to thank my, no one, because I am here on my own business. Screw you all.
And how does it make you feel?
A little bit excited.
Alright, we're gonna take a commercial break. During this time, you guys are free to walk around, stretch your legs, and do commercials.
Butter. Don't you like butter?
I like butter.
That was so close. That's what I'm saying, butter.
And we're back. Today on our show, we have Vegan Gains.
Hi, I'm Vegan Gains, and I like the broccoli.
Oh no, he's dying because he's choking on vegans.
No. He just eats vegans.
A vegan once tried to scale Mount Everest. He died.
Because he's vegan. Anyways. Yeah. Welcome back. Wait, go to a commercial.
Good job. Here, I'm taking a fan. I am the host.
Okay. I have found the word.
The word? What's the word?
Alright, I guess it's three.
Bird is the word.
I'm waiting for the word.
Seconds for it. No, we got the word.
Okay. White Castle shit.
Oh, White Castle's a burger thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, a burger poop?
I'm gonna say,
I'm going with
McDonald's.
I'm going with burger poop.
I'm going with McDonald's for now.
So we have...
Fast food in general.
So, Shy Guy, you're gonna go with that White Castle shit means a burger poop?
Yes.
And Tanner, you're going with it being a synonym for a fast food joint?
Yes.
Alright. Well, looks like Shy Guy...
More than a fifth grader?
Well, it looks like Shy Guy's smarter than you, so...
Fuck yeah.
I'm not.
All the ways of not paying attention in college.
And here is the official definition. This is gonna be hard to get through. One of the most stinky and wettest.
I already like the sound of this.
Wettest shits in existence. The White Castle shit.
Oh my gosh.
Is the insanely powerful crap you take after consuming those grease wand burgers from the White Castle food chain. Characteristics.
Oh my god. Here, pull up the definition, I'll read it.
Having to hover above the bowl. I can't do it.
Here, I'm pulling it up. I'll read it. Watch my dyslexia kick in.
All right, ready for this? Y'all ready for this? No, I got this. No, shh. All right, I got it. No. I'm trying to like get a really deep voice here, and it's like kicking my ass.
One of the most stinkiest.
No, stop. Get
it. One of the most stinkiest.
You can't handle it.
One of the most stinkiest and wettest shits in experience. A White Castle shit is an insanely powerful crab you take after consuming the greasy Whataburger from the White Castle food chain. Characteristics of a White Castle shit include hovering above your ball from time to time while sitting in order to avoid the
No, this shouldn't be a challenge on its own. It's just trying to say this without laughing a single time.
Previous facts, the smell is so much like White Castle burgers that it makes other people in the room hungry. Number three, this sticks to the bowl so bad that you have to use your roommate's. You have to use your roommate's toothbrush to scrub it off. Person X, sniff. Oh. Wait, no, I'm person Y.
I'll give you one, but they're already in the bowl. They're already in the bowl at the moment. There was just...
That was just a funny... Just start your smelling. I'm going to have blast out the White Castle shit in the minute or two. So you're gonna want to use the bathroom. Do it now.
It's all yours, man. I'm gonna get a sack.
I'm literally crying.
I'm literally crying. See, I know how to pick an excellent word. All right.
I'm very proud of you, actually. White Castle, nasty shit, Belgrande shit, turds, poop, porcelain pony, explosion, explosion. It's made by old man with like, I'm scrolling. I got nothing else to say about this. I just. And the winner is
not you, really, basically.
It's actually Durgistan.
Oh. Sweet.
Yeah, so if you're down in a later episode, we should do like a winners episode.
No, one of our gaming videos we should just have a window open and it's gonna be Durgistan eating cake just throughout the entire game.
No, I think that we should do an episode where me take him, like, no, because we agree it was going to be ice cream, I think.
Hey, I am totally cool with cake, though. I mean, straight up.
I don't love you enough to buy cake. Cake costs too much.
Oh, well, fuck you, too.
Yeah, glad you know where you belong.
I offered cake.
He offered cake. I didn't. So here's the plan.
Okay.
We're going to do an episode where we all go down to somewhere fancy to get... This keyword, somewhere fancy. I'll get you a scene. And, yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, it'll be fabulous.
We can go get sushi.
No, we're gonna get you ice cream. It's gonna be great. You're gonna love it. So, gents.
Why not both?
Expect a little vlog or something of us doing that. Who knows, maybe we'll see Shia.
Oh, dude, hell yeah. Dude, Baskin Robbins ice cream cake.
Oh, that stuff's great.
This stuff's shit.
Oh, yeah.
That sounds really good. We're not sponsored, by the way. We are never sponsored.
No one's sponsored
for us. Gosh, someday we're probably going to get like a small blog to like sponsor us and we're going to cry.
This podcast brought to you by Bitter Hatred.
Audacity, or not Audacity, Audacity is a music software. Audible. Audible is the people that does the podcasts.
This podcast. Everyone except us.
This podcast is brought to you by Dottable. It's like Audible, but with dots. It's Audible for the blind.
Wait, Audible is blind.
Good job. Good job. You did your best. You tried. You just... I... Good... P for participation.
P for dick.
Good job. Good job.
What?
He's trying... You know, maybe asking him what he's doing. He's doing his best.
Oh, okay.
Sadly, isn't good enough.
Speaking of not good enough, we're gonna end this not good enough podcast here.
Because Tanner sucks.
You're welcome.
I feel like this was a podcast for us, and then Dragostan was just in the background, like, I'm Dragostan, I'm still here. Don't
forget. Yeah.
That's kind of how it was, but you know what? I'm happy that you joined.
Yeah. I'm still here.
Things were coming, yes, at like 1:30
a.m., by the way.
And I have to go to work tomorrow. I don't think you have to go to work tomorrow, but.
I'm off.
Yes, yeah, and I.
You know, me and Durgis are actually friends IRL.
You're a fucking retard.
You know, IRL. You can't just say, like, you know, in the real, not virtual world, right? And
I don't think so, actually. I don't want to be friends in the real world.
Well, that's fine.
Secretly, you're like giddy with joy that you don't have to be secret.
Okay. I would just like to point out that the Urban Dictionary definition for 7 is the number after 6, you fucking morons!
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Look up my name on Urban Dictionary.
Shy guy?
Yeah.
We're gonna look up all of our names on Urban Dictionary.
Actually, your real name has a very good search result for it.
Thank you.
Alright, so here, I'm gonna go ahead and go with mine as I end off, because I probably need to go to sleep, because I'm tired as can be. So, Douglas, a very old name from the 16th century, Scottish in origin, meaning from the Dark River. A man who has deep insights, mystical powers, and isn't afraid to explore both the dark and light sides of life, seeing them as all one. A person of great understanding, having wisdom that accrues with age. Very public persona, but deeply private in many ways. Don't bother trying to fool, outwit, or fully understand him, man. He is Douglas, sees all, knows all, confounds all. Okay, I'd just like to point out that's very epic.
That was very...
Like, straight up.
Let's hear mine. My full name is Starfish Sex. Sex with a girl's arms. As possible.
Go back to mine. We're gonna be serious. Get out of here. Alright.
The definition of shy guy. A man who... Read this, Tanner.
Okay.
A man who, instead of using an open urinal to pee in...
Shit.
Goes into the stall. This man would not have to do anything other than number one. There was an open urinal between the two large black men. I decided to go shy guy.
That actually is pretty, that's pretty accurate. I pee in stalls all the time because I just don't like standing around people.
Yeah, that's accurate.
The rule is that there's always...
Hashtag small penis, hashtag frightened, hashtag scared, hashtag shy, hashtag timid.
Wait, say what?
That's all the hashtags, that one definition.
Oh, okay. And there's also the rule of, you know, the space. Like, if there are 3 urinals, you do not use the middle urinal ever. That is the buffer zone. It's only there because they needed a urinal to be there. But it's not to be used. That should be the cleanest urinal in the entire bathroom, because no one should be using it.
I agree to the fullest extent. Here, Shy Guy just looked at my definition.
My name.
All right.
What is this?
Tanner. I'm not kidding. He actually typed it in, and this is what came up.
Fox like a tiger.
Ravenously sexual
appetite. Every time he comes, he produces a court. Every time he comes, he produces a court. Makes every woman he sleeps with him sex slaves forever. Whoa, last night I had sex with a tanner. My room was soaked.
And I get shy stall peeing.
Okay.
Stall peeing.
So,
and the one that hashtag is a small penis.
I found a, for your actual name. I won't say your actual name, but
don't read the definition in case we're like super good at that.
Okay, well, I'll read part of it. Like, here. So, sex drive maniac.
Fuck yeah.
Accurate. I'm not gonna lie, it's pretty accurate. Just like mine. Well, cool. I'm glad we all learned something about each other.
I'm pretty sure that one thing I was in real life probably went into Urban Dictionary and typed that in
I'm just gonna say this now. I think that I'm pretty glad that we learned something about each other. Like, for example, we learned that he's a urinal.
I actually do pee in stalls.
I do that too.
I really don't care.
Like, I'm pretty sure everyone does that.
And let's see, we learned that you are just completely epic, and you have like this whole big life story, and how like you got a future ahead of you.
I mean,
and now you have a chance at life.
I mean,
that we learned that I am just a sex-driven.
You're just like a total horn dog.
I'm a god of sex.
Wow, last night I had sex with a tanner. My room was soaking. Just like a pussy.
Okay, well, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and just, you know, go over here and, you know,
it was great seeing you guys.
I'm Durgistan, bye-bye.
But, he just left us. See you, Shy Guy. Good night, guys. Thanks for watching, gents. Like, comment, subscribe. I'm leaving. Goodbye.
Fuck.